call the play-by-play once again. Here is the Deacon, Randy Wilson.
Hoyle stands back at his own goal line. Here's the kick, and it will come down to Coyle. He'll take it in at the 4, to the 5, he's to the 10, to the 15, to 20, straight up the middle, and he is hit it, hit hard, rocks at the 21-yard line. And Beechwood will have it first and 10 at the 21.
Beechwood comes up to the line of scrimmage in an I formation. They've got one receiver split to the far side.
And here's the handoff on the pitch to the outside with a football is Bishop. He's got some running room near the 27-yard line, brought down by Sean Abney.
Down and 4 for Beechwood. Second play from scrimmage. Here comes Beechwood. Under center is Wisher.
Second down, and Wisher will give it off as it sees Bishop. And Bishop's not going anywhere this time as the Juggernauts spell that out. Dominic Carlotta in there on the tackle, no gain. And it'll bring up a third down now and 4 for the Beechwood Tigers. Just pull the offense together, club.
That team will be most successful tonight. But the first third down play of the game, the Tigers have it. Bishop will move in motion to the near side.
Wisher is underneath. He'll go back to throw it. Looking downfield, steps up, throws, hits his man. That's Lift, and Lift will gather it in and rumble to about the 38-yard line. So the tight end with the pass, Jeremiah Lee in on the tackle. But first down yardage is Wisher locked position, and Craig Wilmhall for Beechwood in years gone by. But I really thought that Wisher played extremely well last year in the state championship game, a game that Beechwood lost by 1 point to the club from Mayfield.
Right out to both sides. Here's the handoff around the left side. Brian Bishop looking for somebody. He's to the 40, to the 45. Still on his feet across midfield. And just as he steps across midfield, steps out of bounds at the 49-yard line into Lloyd territory. Another first down, and Beechwood on the move early.
Well, a pick up a 13 on that carry by Brian Bishop. He now has 3 carries hit for 20 Tigers here in quarter number 1.
First down, ball at the 49. Wide out to both sides. Lone back in the backfield. And the handoff is straight up the middle with the football is Wolfack, and he gets maybe a yard, and that is all. That'll bring up a second down at 9 now for the Jugs. Chris Adams in on the tackle.
And we'll quickly check the Lloyd Juggernaut defense for Merritt and Lee. The defensive back, Brown, Raymer, and Thornton. Second down and all at 9 now for Beechwood. Ball at the 48-yard line inside Lloyd territory.
Up to the far side. Here's a toss to the outside on the screen pass. Bishop. Bishop to the 45. Duke steps to around the 40. We got a flag.
Yep, that one is going to come on step, Randy, as he blocked from behind. This will be a clipping penalty, and that will nullify the big game. Take it back. Right now, Brian Bishop certainly getting a lot of work here in the early going for Mike Daigle's 0-1 Beechwood Tigers. 9:32 to go in the first quarter of play. Other games in action tonight. Brown Miller can full swing now, although certainly it's, I think, unseasonably warm for the early part of September in Northern Kentucky.
Second down and a bunch, what, 20?
Yep.
And here's the handoff. No, play action. Wisher will throw to the outside. He hooks up with Ratliff. Ratliff tries to cut the corner and is brought down on the nice individual tackle at the 40-yard line by John Baker. Baker was right there, smelled at the screen, and one-on-one, Wisher and company. We'll see if they can convert here on this third down and 20. Wide out to both sides. Lone back in the backfield. Man in motion. Wisher will go back to throw the football.
He's swept out of the pocket and he's dropped back at the 27-yard line.
Dominic Carlotta in there once again, as well as Jeremiah Lee coming through the linebacker slot. That'll bring up a fourth down, and Beechwood will have to
punt on Earl Sheffield, but these twin safeties both talented as well, as I believe going back is Brown and the other one, Abby.
I think so. It will come down, and Brown will, well, he looked like he was going to come and grab it at the 40. Did not, but it took a big Lloyd bounce up to the 47-yard line. And that is where Lloyd will have it. John Baker is your split in. Scott Merritt plays the tight.
Gabbard at the nose guard. Rayburn and Massey at first down and 10 for Lloyd.
And off the simple straight up the middle. Bulls is way to near the 50-yard line. And in there on the tackle, Joey Lift. In fact, they will mark him across the 50. He got almost to the 48-yard line of Beechwood, so into the Tigers' territory.
He set all sorts of weightlifting records here at Lloyd High School, where he's receiving the selling carry and some carry research before the game.
Second down. Here's a fumble, and Lee can't get on it. It's on the field, and I think Beechwood might have the football. This exchange from center, and the Beechwood Tigers have come up with it.
They certainly do, Randy, and I believe it.
Getting up off the bottom of the pile.
Oh, gosh.
Ball at the 47-yard line. Quickly back on offense. Wide out to the far side. That is Wayne Scott over there. Man in the slot. That's Bishop. He will go in motion. Near the far. And Wisher will go back to throw the football. Look, throws out the flat. And too far for Bishop. Heavy pressure being applied there by the
Right tackle, Chris Adams. Field on the way, not allowing the linebackers to come up and just play run defense. Beechwood always known for their passing game, and some razzle-dazzle. I'm sure we'll see some here tonight.
Wisher back to throw the football. Look, steps up. Hooks up with his tight end, Joey Lift. He makes the grab at the 35-yard line. Brought down by linebacker Abney, but Lift over the middle. It's been there twice for good yardage both times.
Lift, a big, bulky player. He can block well, but he also does a nice job of releasing out into pass play pattern.
Ratliff to the far. Wayne's got to the near. Handoff straight up the middle. Pulling his way as Wolfbeck to the 30-yard line, I believe. And then on the tackle was Dewey Martin. Was that Wolfbeck on the carry?
I believe it was. And
yeah, Lift was all over the place.
Yeah. There's a flag out on the field.
Oh, there we go. That's the 29-yard line. Didn't see it until everybody unfiled. There he was by Wolfbeck. Would have got a personal foul. Slap to the head, I think, is what the official said. Slap to the helmet by one of the Lloyd Juggernauts, and that personal foul is going to move it down to about the 15-yard line.
That'll be first and 10 for Beechwood from right there, and John Wisher is bringing the club up to realign the huddle. 6:39 to go in a score at the game-winning touchdown.
Sounds familiar. Morrison and Wayne Scott. Wide out, tandem to the left side.
I think Bishop's got to be the man here.
On this first down, handoff to Bishop, straight up the middle, powers his way to near the 10-yard line. And that'll set up a second down and six from the 10. John Abney and Asher both in on the tackle for Lloyd.
And Randy, a third off at the Beechwood 48-yard line, so they move the ball very effectively. Second down and five, ball at the 10-yard line in Lloyd territory.
And the handoff to Bishop, up the middle to the 5-yard line, inside the 5 and down to the 3.
Wow, I thought he had a chance to get in from there, but he did not do so. But great blocking along the offensive line, especially along the right side. And Abney and Asher again had got the lineup in the backfield as well this time. It's going to be a full house backfield now for Beechwood. Also, Joey Bishop in the game, so both Bishop brothers in there.
Handoff to Wayscott off the left side, looking for some running room for a bit of daylight. And he gets marked down right at the 1-yard line.
Wow.
Good, pretty good defensive surge on the right side. After it looked like following a couple of blocks, Wainscott was going to be able to get in
every single tackle. This time, the Beechwood Tigers come up to the line of scrimmage with a two tight end set, second and goal from the one.
And here's the handoff to Joey.
No, sir.
Nope. Josh Bishop trying to get in, and he is stopped. In fact, he loses a few yards back to near the 3.
Wow, and great defensive surge that time by Dominic Carlotta. And also the big play here, third down and goal from the 4 for Beechwood.
Full house backfield again on this third down and 4. Wisher brings him up underneath, and he keeps the football, and he's not going to make it. He got about a yard, and that is all. And that's going to bring up a fourth down and decision time for Mike Giggle. It'll be fourth and goal to go from the 3-yard line.
Well, Dominic Carlotta was one of the young men in on the tackle. The other guy that was in there was one of the big fellas, Tyson Vogelpohl. Fell to the turf. No harm and no win for Beechwood, but here it is. Fourth and goal from the 3.
Fourth down, and with the football at the right side is Bishop fighting for the goal line, and I don't think he made it. He got to the 1 and got pushed back by Dominic Carlotta and also John Baker.
Well, great defensive goal line stand by the Lloyd Juggernauts, and we talked about the tough defense and how important that would be tonight. And Lloyd, I think, is the interference. He didn't have a chance. Well, Lloyd, though, faced with a potential safety situation here. They're pinned back at their 1.
Here's the handoff to Abney, and Abney is stuck after a gain of up to about the 4-yard line. So a gain of a couple anyway, and it'll bring up a second down with 3:30 to go.
As I told you, I probably jinxed these teams. I thought it was going to be a high scoring affair tonight. So far, no scoring.
Second down, we got whistles all over the place, and a flag is down. So obviously somebody lined up offside.
Yep, right at the line of scrimmage because the penalty came from the line judge along the far side. I think it's going to be against Lloyd. Nope, they actually got a 5-yard penalty against Beechwood. That's a big call and advantage.
And 2.
Now this is a situation in the past where Woody Ficini will come out throwing, even though he's got the full house backfield right now.
And here's the handoff. First back, Drew Simple with some big yardage up to around the 17-yard line. That'll move to 6. And a new 4-4, the Lloyd Juggernauts,
John, with the white numerals, while Beechwood comes out in their white uniforms with the red numerals. Two wide receivers split to the far side, and a man on the slot as well.
Just a low back in the backfield. He'll get the football to the 20-yard line and beyond. The 21 is where they're marking down. Knocked off his feet by Claiborne. And that'll bring up the second down.
Brian Bishop and Brad Foss are the defensive secondary men for the Tigers of Mike Yeagle.
Abney and Sipple in the backfield. And Lee on the pitch to the outside to Abney, trying to cut the corner. He's in the 25, still on his feet, breaks the tackle to the 30, and falls down to the 32-yard line. So he bounced off a couple of would-be tacklers and pushed it all the way up to the 32. And once again, they come out with a full house backfield.
And the Lloyd fans are excited about the way things are going here tonight. And
here's
the
handoff on the left side, and with the football to the 31-yard line. New player that just checked into the ball game. That's Kleiner. And
back off from Wooten Field in Park Hills, Kentucky. The Covington Catholic Colonels will entertain A-back side Lyle Raiders.
Second down and nine. Low back in the backfield as Abney and Lee will go back to throw it. Looks down, throws down the middle. Got a man, but picked off. Oh, almost picked off at the 50-yard line as Bishop had it in his hands and could not bring it down. That was Brian Bishop that had it for a moment.
Quarter number one, a couple of receivers come to the near side, namely John Baker and Sean Brown.
Family will come off, Biffle Malone back in the backfield, Lee will go back to throw the football. Steps up in the pocket, throws down,
going
left side, looking for Brown, incomplete.
Good breakup back there by Scott Coyle, the junior.
The defensive play, Coyle was right with him stride for stride as they were trying to go to Brown. And around,
he's back deep for Beechwood.
Bishop and Coyle are back there. And Lloyd set the punt away. Here's the punt. Good booming kick. Will drive Bishop all the way back to the 22-yard line. Bishop will take it to the 25. He's to the 30, and he is dropped right at the 30-yard line.
Yep, he got rocked that time, and one of the young men in there on the tackle for the Lloyd Juggernauts was Corey Siffle, who came up with a big hit, Randy, but then they decided to go with a run inside the 5-yard line. They had four opportunities to score on their second offensive possession, but Lloyd held them out of the end zone.
Full fix, straight up the middle to the 32. Gain of a couple, brings up second down and eight. Sean Abney in on the tackle, the linebacker for the Lloyd Juggernauts. Also Siffle in there as well. On defense. So far, nothing yet, and that's a good sign. At least they might have that straightened out.
That's true.
Second down and seven. Swisher will go back to throw the football. Pump fake. He'll look long. Throws the fly pattern. Right side. Incomplete. Too far for the intended receiver. That was Ratliff. John Baker in on the coverage. Did pretty good coverage. He had Ratliff like a blanket. His
line in all sorts of different offensive formations. Sometimes two backs in the backfield. Sometimes one. Sometimes three. Sometimes two tight ends. This time, I formation in the backfield. Third and seven for Beechwood.
Third down and seven. The option.
Oh,
the outside. And Bishop is rocked at the 25-yard line by Sean Abney. And Abney was in there so quick on Bishop, he almost caught the pitch.
He really did, Randy. If he would have caught it, it would have been 6 points for Lloyd. So you talk about reading the defensive play right, Sean.
Long with Brown. The Brown and Kleiner are back.
And they've been trying to kick the ball to Brown for whatever reason here in the first half of play.
Here's the snap. Here's the kick. It will come down to Brown. Brown at the 32. Duke steps to the 35. Still on his feet to the 40 and brought down at the 41-yard line. On a 42 yards. Nice booming kick there. It's still pretty good field position for the Lloyd Juggernauts.
Lloyd now offensively working against the Beechwood defense that last year only allowed 9 points a game, and Beechwood's defense played very well here in the first half of play. Lloyd has it first and 10.
Here's the pitch to the outside with the football to the 40-yard line. Is John Baker, who just checked into the backfield. Brian Bishop in on the tackle, and that didn't go anywhere. That'll bring up the second down and 10, so they put Bishop at the tail position and run the Baker at the
tip. We had a different Lloyd team this year than it was last year. Again, they went unbeaten in the regular season and lost in the playoffs to the eventual AA state champion, Breathitt County.
Brown went in the slot. Siffle Malone back in the backfield. Man in motion is Thornton. Here's the handoff. Siffle up the middle, and Siffle is pushed back at the 40-yard line. Good defensive surge once again by the Beechwood Tigers. It's getting in there.
This was one of the guys.
See a 78 in there. So it was Woolley at 76 that was in on the play as well. Brings up a third down and 12 now. Trip step to the far side. Lee will go back to throw football. He's got Rowland in the flat. A flag is down. Round of the 50 to the 45 and brought down and around the 43-yard line. But a flag is down back to the 35-yard line. This was coming back.
Randy, I think they got the center that time. Dave Aikman for Lloyd on the holding call. We'll see if it does come back against Lloyd. But a well-designed pass play from the Lloyd Juggernauts. So I think it's all going to be for naught. Again, a very young, inexperienced offensive line with the exception, really, of Dominic Carlotta.
And it will be coming back. I'd like to thank a couple more folks this evening. Custom Trophy, a leader in awards since 1983. No order too small or too large. Stop on Main Street in Florence and Hebron Bank. A fast and convenient service. Stop at a Hebron Bank near you.
And Randy, I'm going to quiz you quickly.
Oh, here we go.
Last year, Breathitt County, remember how awesome they were?
Yes.
Their quarterback?
Whalen. Chapman.
I thought it was Williams and
Marshall.
Eastern Kentucky.
Eastern.
That's right. Who was the guy he always hooked up with? That you don't know.
First down, Lee will go back to throw it. Rolls to the right. Lee still looking.
Way down.
Throws way down. Baker. Right side for Baker and well out of bounds. And pass is intercepted about 5 yards out of bounds by Bryant Bishop. And that'll bring up a fourth down. He's been waiting in the wings for a long time. Went to Eastern, expected to be quarterback. John Stockett came down from Penn State.
Right.
They had the kid from Georgia Tech after that the next year. He's been waiting for a long time, but he's getting a chance this year. Here's the snap and the punt. It will come down to Coyle at the 42. He's to the 45-yard line and brought down at the 47. A nice individual tackle. I believe that was Kleiner that was in there on the stop. A punt of 30.
It's been too long, but, you know, Coach Curry is a funny guy. I mean, he likes to stick with the veterans as long as possible, but the crowd, I was at election a couple days this week, they're really antsy. They want Cats to be in there.
Ball at the 48-yard line. Here's the handoff, and Bishop gets the call off the right side.
That was Johnson at that time. Corey Sissel went on the tackle. The double-A final last year went into overtime, and Chapman was the guy that delivered the goods for Breathitt County. Again, I was very, very impressed with his talents and his voice.
Second down at the 50, and back to throw on the play action is Wisher.
He'll throw. He's got lift at the 30, to the 25, 20, rumbling to the 15, inside the 15-yard line, and brought down at around the 10.
Joey Lift with the catch, and Lift is pretty big as tight ends go. 6'3", 241, and when I said rumbled, I meant rumbled, and he was caught from behind inside the 10-yard line.
Had an opportunity earlier in the first quarter of this game to score with first and goal. They didn't get in, but again, they'll have a try right now.
And the handoff off the left side. Inside the 5-yard line is Bryant Bishop, and he will get to about the 4. Don Abbey in on the tackle. And it'll be second. Once again, a goal to go.
Good rush. By too much on the run. Beechwood down at the single-A level certainly does not do that. And I think that's why they've enjoyed so much success over the years.
Second and goal to go from the 4-yard line. Bishop will go back to throw the football. Throws over the middle. And it's knocked away and almost picked off. Somebody got a big ball up there and knocked it away. They were trying to go to Joey List once again, the tight end over the middle.
The linebacker had coverage on him. Then went out for the pass play. It's third down and goal from the 3. I would expect a run once again for Beechwood.
Wisher, here's the pitch, Bishop. Right side Bishop looking for the end zone, and he gets in there. Sidesteps the would-be defender and gets into the end zone from 4 yards down, and Beechwood has taken a 6-0 lead with 7:36 left to go in the first quarter.
Well, good lead blocking out there as they ran the old pitch play, and Bishop did a lot on his own. 6-0, 7:36 to go in quarter number one.
First half, I should say.
Lost to Lloyd last year at Edgar McNabb Field in Beechwood, 21-20, but tonight the Tigers have a 6-0 advantage. And remember, last year, Randy, Beechwood missed an extra point, and that proved to be the difference in the game.
Wolfpack in to attempt the extra point. Snap on the tee, kick is up, and it is
no good
as it slips off to the left-hand side. So 6-0, Beechwood on top, 7:36 to play in the first half.
Wolfpack missed the extra point try for the Tigers, but their drive, the touchdown scoring drive for Beechwood goes 5 plays and 52 yards, capped by the 3-yard touchdown run by Brian Bishop. It's 6-0 Beechwood, and the Tigers lost the ball in the air.
It will come down to Brown. Short kick. He takes it at the 10 to the 15 to the 20 to the 25-yard line. He's to the 5.
He might
be gone.
He's to the 45. They'll have to catch him from behind if they're going to get him. He's to the 20, the 15, the 10, and he will score a touchdown. Randy, that is an 88-yard touchdown return by the young man, Sean Brown, an outstanding baseball player, a fine guard on Jeff Jump's basketball team, and tonight he ties the game up. Sometimes things have a bit of a lull. Right now, Lloyd out there trying to take the lead in this game, 7-6. The extra point try by Beechwood was no good. Can Lloyd convert?
Jeremiah Lee to attempt the extra point. The kick is up, and it is good. 7-6. Lloyd on top, 7:20 to go in the first half, and we'll be back on the Star Sports Radio Network. Jeremiah Lee approaches to kick it off. Lloyd leads 7-6. Coyle will gather in at the 7. He's to the 10, to the 15, to the 20. Cuts it to the outside of the 25, to the 30-yard line. And a good run by Coyle as he gets to the 35-yard line. Tom Rowland in on the tackle. So for the second time in as many weeks, the Beechwood Tigers kick off.
It's funny. I was right behind him. He ran up to the wedge and was literally, I think, blocked from view. And it just took that one step so that the block could be executed, and away he went.
Here's the handoff to Bishop up the middle, and he is stopped cold at the 30-yard line. Loss of a couple. Dewey Martin in on the tackle
by Sean Brown. An 88-yard touchdown return by Sean. And Beechwood right now, I think a bit reeling. They got two tight ends in the game now.
Second down. Here's the handoff to Bishop up the middle. He's to the 35-yard line. It falls forward about the 39. Brings up the third down for Beechwood. Jeremiah Lee in on the tackle as well as Abney, the two linebackers. And Marky
Morrison, a 5'10 senior. He'll go to the far side of the field. We're lining up to this side will be Brad Wainscott as a receiver. Go down at six. The passing situation for Beechwood.
Back to throw. Heavy pressure. He'll roll to the right. He'll throw it back over the middle. And it's going to be incomplete. They were trying to get it to Wolfbeck. And not able to hold on to it. The middle screen is what they were trying to set up. But Wolfbeck tried to run before he had the football at the 35-yard line.
They kick the ball away. 5:48 to go in the second quarter play. 7-6. Wood on top of Beechwood.
Brown and Kleiner back. Here's the snap. Wolfbeck, nice high kick. This will come down to Kleiner. Loses it, kicks it, picks it up at the 22, cuts it to the outside, and is brought down right there. That was an adventure from the get-go. And the punt of 41 yards as Wolfbeck launches some serious punts this evening.
There is, but he missed the most important try he's had tonight. Well, Lamy, the guy that had both of those tries go awry, did score a big goal this week for the Boone County Rebel soccer team.
First down, man in motion. And with the football is Lee. He'll run the option to the left side.
Oh,
and he'll pitch it. It's the last moment to Abney. Abney will get to around the 24-yard line. He was trying to find some daylight. It did for a second, but it closed very quickly on the pursuit by the Beechwood Tigers. And boy, Lee waited an awful long time to pitch that football. And that was very dangerous.
There was Josh Morrison on the tackle there.
It was very iffy. He actually got hit, came free with his arms, and then got rid of it. But the inexperience, you're going to get someone that's taking some risk. And if he's anything like his brother.
Second down, Lee will throw over the middle to Rowan, and Rowan to the 39-yard line. So that's first down yardage to the 39, lift in on the tackle. But to complete the thought of what
Lloyd just completed his first pass of the contest, it comes at the 440 mark of quarter number two, a 15-yard strike.
And off to Abney up the middle. He's to the 40-yard line. It falls to the 42. Gain of a couple. Bring up a second down and eight with 4:30. And counting left here in the first half. And Lloyd on top, 7-6. I'd like to thank a couple of more from
the Greater Cincinnati Nautical Championship Club. Three straight seasons playing for his father at the C, B, and A level. And he's in motion right now.
Here's the handoff and a fumble. But
Lee's
got it back at the 45-yard line. Lee was trying to stick it in the gut, I believe, of Abney. And Abney was too far away, and he really pushed it out there. It bounced off of the right hip, but bounced
7, Beechwood 6. Ball at the Lloyd 45-yard line at 3rd and 4.
3rd and 4. Lee underneath. Throw back in the backfield. And Lee will go back to throw the football.
Wow.
Steps up in the pocket, flushed out. Now he's going to run it, and he will not get the first down as he falls to near the 48-yard line and had to get to the 49, and that's going to bring up a fourth down, and Lloyd is probably going to have to punt this ball away. And there on the tackle was Dan Woolley. Decision time for Rudy Cicini here, Kevin. 4th and 1.
2:45 and above. And now introducing in Westchester, Ohio, the Fairways at Wetherington. So when you're looking for quality, value, and a tradition of boating.
The penalty is illegal procedure against the
is the right decision. Punt the ball away. Their defense has played sensationally here in the first half of play. Lloyd leads 7-6. 2:47 to go here in quarter number two.
Bishop and Coyle are back at the 20-yard line. Here's the snap and the punt. High kick and short. Will bounce out of bounds. Not a good kick at all. In fact, they'll mark it at the 37-yard line. A punt of just 20 yards.
Beechwood really showing the big play attack tonight. His list has had an outstanding night at tight end. 3 catches for 72 yards. Brian Bishop's been the workhorse at tailback. 36 yards on 12 carries.
Here's a fumble in the backfield, and
Lloyd's
got the football. That's the 39-yard line.
Got it. And Chris Adams, the senior, hops on the football, so the turnovers are now even. And as you can see, the right decision, the smart decision by Rudy Cicini gets the ball back. You love it when you're right. And that happens 99 times out of 99.
Lee will go back to throw. Now he's flushed out of the pocket. He'll pull it down and run the football, and he's brought down at the 40-yard line. Loss of a couple of yards. That's Dan Woolley in there on the sack, and that'll bring up second down as he loses one with 2:22 left.
But nevertheless, Lloyd leads 7-0. And again, Lee has that ability, much like his brother Randy did, of making things happen.
Here's the handoff, straight up the middle to the 30-yard line. It's Sipple to the 25 and brought down at the 24. The quick hitter, they had the trip set out to the right. And Beechwood
timeout. But it came right after a big 18-yard scamper by fullback Corey Sipple. It's first and 10 now for Lloyd at the Beechwood 23-yard line.
He will roll to the left, looks downfield, steps up, throws long. Going for the end zone, and he fell down. Rowan fell down, and then the defender behind him fell down as well, and nobody came up with the football.
That was Wainscott that fell down behind him, Randy, and you're right, nobody came up with the football. But Bishop was back there as well, and I'll tell you something.
Most pattern is he was going down to the right side. Second down and 10.
He obviously a favorite receiver, quarterback Jeremiah Lee.
Ball at the 23-yard line. Lee will go back to throw it again. Roll, now step up, throw the screen pass, incomplete. Somebody might have got a hand on it. They were trying to go to Abney at the 25-yard line. Good pressure being applied by Massey. A closure or even a first down here with a minute 42 to go in the first half.
I think if they could pick up about another 7 yards, Randy, they'd be in business. Right now, Brown is out to the far side along with two other receivers for Lloyd.
Lee will go back to throw. Now he's flushed out. Now he'll roll with the left side. He'll pull it down and run with the football. Trying to get some yardage. Not out of bounds yet. Turn, spin, gets some more yardage. Close to the 17-yard line. That's not going to be enough for the first down. They're going to mark it at the 16, but he could have got himself in the field goal range.
Randy, I think he did. How many yards did I say he needed? You didn't even listen to me, but I said range angle for the kicker Lee to try to attempt one. But
on the
no timeout
16,
left.
Fourth and two, handoff up the middle, and weaving his way. I don't think he made it. Stiffle, he had to get to near the 14-yard line, and they're going to mark him down at the 15. I believe he's going to be short, and Beechwood's going to take over at the 15-yard line with a minute 7 to go here in the first half. And that indeed is going to be the case. They're not even going to measure, I don't think. And Beechwood will come out, and they'll have the ball at the 15-yard line.
Beechwood to get a big play or two together and try to take the lead going into halftime. Right now the Tigers trail by one.
At the 15-yard line, here's the handoff, set up the middle, Wolfpack, and he just dives forward for a couple. And I think Mike Eagle is going to be content to run this clock out. Take that one.
Lucas is done. Yeah, Roy Lucas has done an outstanding job, I think, taking over the helm of the Wildcats last season. And now it'll be second down and 7. And again, I'm not going to play coy. I think Beechwood might try to go for a bomb.
Fisher will hand off to Wolfex straight up the middle. Wolfex to the 30-yard line, to around the 35 with a 19-second. Oh, you're right. Bishop with the carry that time, not Wolfex, as he's here at the half. Mike Woods will try to corral him before he goes into the first half locker room. 7-6 is your score. The Lloyd Juggernauts on top of the Beechwood Tigers here as we go into the first half locker room. Stay with us. You're tuned to the Star Sports Radio.
Knock on him to throw him off balance, to at least break down the timing between Lisher and himself.
I'm not sure anybody can bump off of Joey Lisch. He's a load at that tight end position.
No. Lisher's doing the bumping at 6'3", 241. There's no doubt about that. But you're right, Mike. He's done a good job. And again, I think Beechwood will mix it up. I think they'll throw on first down some in the second half. Beechwood's got to kick the ball off to Lloyd. Under the Star Sports Network, Lloyd will be traveling right to left over AM 1320 and a half, and actually in quarter number 3.
Brown and Kleiner are standing back at the 5, and I'll bet they kick it away from Brown.
Yeah, and weirdly enough, they were kicking it to Brown in the first half of play, so he torched them for 6.
Here's the kick. It will come. Well, Brown will let it bounce. He'll gather it in at the 10, and I think he took a knee. No, they're going to say he was up at the 20 and up to the 23-yard line. I thought he caught that ball, Kevin, and he had a knee on the ground at the 10-yard line, but I guess they
Brown, but didn't have the football an awful lot in the first half of play. Again, Jeremiah's only complete pass was to Tom Rowan in the first half of play. That one for 15 yards.
High formation. Here's the handoff to Kleiner off the left side, and he is brought down in a hurry at the 20-yard line, a loss of about a yard, and that'll bring up the second down and 11.
Once again, the starting linebackers and one junior in the defensive backfield, but the junior class representing themselves very well here tonight.
Second down, once again, high formation, and back to throw will be Lee. He'll
Rowan
throw. He's got Rowan and incomplete as they're trying to hook up with him at the 45-yard line. In there on the coverage was Brad Foss.
Now for Lloyd, 11:14 to go in the third quarter of play. Lloyd with the football.
Right out to both sides. Man of the slot is Baker. Back to throw is Lee. Pump fake, pump, downhill throw, the right side, and it's going to be incomplete.
And they were going for Brown over there, covered by Bishop, but it falls incomplete, and Lloyd will have to kick the football away. Lead here, John Alford, the former running back, great for Boone County, but fourth down and kick time for Lloyd.
Here's the snap, low, and it's booted away. It will come down. Bishop actually will let it bounce. It'll take a big Lloyd bounce to the 25 to the 20. Bishop will pick it up at the 15-yard line and will be dropped at the 18, a 64-yard punt. 64 yards by John Baker.
Out of certainly that was the kick right there by Baker, as you said, Randy, but Beechwood has it first and 10. Ball is resting really just outside their 15-yard line.
Here's the handoff around the left side with the football is Wayne Scott on the reverse, and he is dropped at the 21-yard line. Scott Merritt, the linebacker, in on the tackle, and some heavy hitting going on down there this evening.
Erlanger tonight. I still miss Sheffield, though, Randy. Sheffield was electrifying.
I know.
Where is he?
That's your other shrine.
That's
right. Tom Duffy. Second down, here's the handoff. Bishop up the middle. Two around the 25-yard line. And looks to be enough for the first down. I think they might call for a measurement here. I don't think he got it. He might be
a play, 7-6. But Lloyd has lead. Beechwood certainly moving the football nicely on the ground here. And I think they'll mix it up now and go to the air.
Slide out to both sides. Here's the handoff straight up the middle. And to the 30-yard line, close to the 30-yard line. Is that Wolfex that got the football that time? Nope, it was, I believe, Bishop again that got the football at 9:27 here in the third. Wide outs to both sides. High formation on this second down. Wisher underneath. Here's play action, and the pitch to the outside, Wayne Scott. Wayne Scott with some room to the 40-yard line and brought down at around the 44.
Well, a good pickup that time of some 15 yards by Wayne Scott, and another first down for Beechwood, so a nice sustained drive for the Tigers. Now,
good yardage to the 44.
I smell a pass for Beechwood.
Wide out to both sides.
Play action would work perfectly in this situation.
Bishop will go in motion, far side of the air on this first down, and Wisher will stick it in the gut of the tailback, who will get to around the 47. That was Wolfek that time, running in the tailback position. They'll mark him at the 46. Merritt and Abney on
to try to come in against the guys that might be running the football. So Beechwood does have it. And again, they got a receiver split to the far side.
Second down from the 46. And Wisher this time will go back to throw the football. Look out in the flat, throws in and out of the hands of Lloyd, who gets just buried at the 50-yard line as Abney locked.
So I think that hurts their chances on this big third down and eight play. But checking in as the receiver to the near side will be Brad Ratliff.
Ratliff to the near, wide out to both sides. And the man in motion is Wayne Scott. Back to throw as Wisher steps up in the pocket, throws downfield, right side, and incomplete. At the 25-yard line, Thornton was in on the coverage. They were trying to get it to Wayne Scott at the 25.
The defense, again, I think, called to the pass, and they stopped him, and Beechwood's going to be forced to kick the football away.
Brown and Kleiner are back, and we got a whistle, and we got to be an official timeout.
No,
Lloyd. Just for Lloyd. So,
but Ackman failed to get out there in time for the special teams play, but it's still fourth down and eight. Beechwood has to kick it away. The fake.
Here's the fake on the left side. It's
step
with the football, cuts it, and didn't make it. On the fourth down, got just a couple of yards up to the 49-yard line, but Lloyd will have great field position at the 49 of Beechwood.
Ball at the 49. Confusion offensively for Lloyd as they finally get their alignment set.
Light outs all over the yard. Now somebody finally comes up on the line. Jeremiah Lee lost the football, popped right back up in his hands, and he is dropped behind the line of scrimmage back across the 50 at the 47. Tom Massey in there, and that was district play, but I think Beechwood a little bit disappointed in themselves at this point with their inability to score many points against Lloyd. Second down at 14. Here's the handoff right side. Kleiner with it. Maybe a yard, and that is all.
And that tackle made by Josh Morris once again, the 5'11 sophomore who's played great tonight with the call from Fort Mitchell.
Morris in there on the stop.
All right, so Sifl, the leading ball carrier we just talked about, out right now with a bell ringer apparently, and it's third down and 14 for Lloyd. You can bet Beechwood's going to be blitzing here.
Lee will go back to throw the football, steps up, throws out
Brown.
The flat, incomplete, trying to get it to Brown out on the left side, and just too far, could not bring it in. Back to Bishop.
And I think you got to credit Beechwood's defense right there, Randy,
yeah,
for that's a momentum shifting possession, and Beechwood's defense got it done. Lloyd started out in their territory.
Bishop and Coyle are back. Here's the punt.
Baker gets it away. They'll get away from it. It will once again take a Lloyd bounce and roll inside the 20 and will go out of bounds at around the 17-yard line. So Beechwood 10 deep one more time. 10 with 6:14 left to go here in the third quarter of play, and Lloyd still holding the 7-6 lead.
Lane's got lined up to the far side.
Here's the handoff. Left side with it is Bishop. Trying to attack the running room. And he gets across the 20 to around the 22-yard line. Scott Merritt in on the stop. And that's going to bring up the second down. Pretty good yardage.
It looks like they'll be getting him back in. Mangy's massaging it now. I'm sure you'll see him real soon.
Mike's going to be an old man. Here, breathing hard there.
He is an old man.
Here's the handoff straight up the middle with the football to the 35-yard line. And now we got a late flag as Wolfeck carried it to the 35 near the 36. And then a late flag comes in. And we'll have to sort this out.
Well, he picked up about 12 yards on the carry.
A player in the vicinity of that.
That should be a clip against Beechwood, though.
Right.
So wasn't in the vicinity, but the infraction took place where? That's the big question.
Yeah,
I picked up 12 yards.
I didn't see a Beechwood player there.
Yeah, I didn't either.
I'm sure Mike Yeagle didn't see one either.
No, but they're talking
moving
right
back
now.
Around the 20.
Yeah, they're talking to defensive captain Chris Adams, who fell on a fumble earlier in the contest. And Tommy Thompson, your referee, sorting things out down there with his fellow compatriots in the striped shirts, and they'll walk it off from the 34-yard line, so that'll move it all the way back to around the 19-yard line, where it'll be third down and long now. Long, long way, and there's a lot of points that are going to be swinging up on the board. You probably want to be able to keep track of them.
Second down and long. Wisher underneath. And he'll go back on the play action. Rolls to the left, throws downfield. He's got lift in and out of his hands at the 35-yard line. He should have come up with that football right in his hands. Lamer in on the coverage, but way up here, well beyond the first down marker.
You're right.
So it's going to bring up a third and seven.
I'm still waiting for that patented Beechwood screen.
Wisher underneath. He'll go back on the play action again.
Yeah,
steps up in the pocket, throws downfield, and in and out of the hands. John Brown with good coverage. Oh, check that, Derek Raymer with good coverage as they were trying to get it to the out.
They kicked the ball away. The injured player was Abney, but he certainly appears to be okay. The ball resting at Beechwood's 19-yard line, so Lloyd appears to be setting up the return.
Brown is back, and it will come down and will bounce at the 45. Take a Beechwood roll and better get away from it. And Lloyd does. It will roll at the 43-yard line, and Beechwood will have it. Or check that, Lloyd will have his first and 10 at the 43 upon a penalty. Don't need to wait until 11:20.
Yeah,
with Chris Grampy.
That's his play action pass, man. It's gonna blow your doors off.
Underneath is Lee, and the handoff on the right side with the football.
Look at that.
And across midfield to around the 45-yard line is Kreiner. Kreiner on the play all the way to the 46, as a matter of fact. It's crossing into Beechwood territory, so a
pass that time at the line of scrimmage, but a good call by Jeremiah. First and 10, Lloyd.
Ball at the 46-yard line.
Two tight end offense now for the Jugs. They look to be pounding it down the throat of Beechwood.
He will give it off straight up the middle to the 45, and that is all. As he has pushed back John Baker in on the carry, and Holman is in there to make the stop, as well as Julie Lift. Hit him one. I'd like to thank a couple.
Ball at the Beechwood 45-yard line. 4 minutes to go in the third quarter. It's Lloyd 7, Beechwood 6. Beechwood missed an extra point in the second quarter. Jeremiah Lee audibilizing at the line of scrimmage. This could be a pass play.
And Lee underneath. Now Lee will roll to the left. Nobody there. He'll keep the ball to the 40-yard line, to the 35, inside the 35, and down to close to the 31-yard line. Got Coyle in on the tackle. They'll mark him down at the 31, and that will be enough for a first down.
Took up a 14 yards by Lee. He now has 40. Sean Abney.
Ball at the 31-yard line. Now Lee, that's some more confusion.
There's going to be a delay of game penalty almost for sure on this play, unless they quickly go to the line of scrimmage and hike.
Coming up, taking a lot of time. They did get it off. Now we got a flag. Here's the reverse on the right side, the inside reverse to the 31, and a fumble, and Beechwood's got the football.
It's all going to be for naught, because there was illegal procedure before the snap of the ball, and that's going to cost Lloyd 5 yards, and it's going to be fortunate for them, because the turnover will not count. The play is dead because of the illegal procedure penalty, if that indeed is the call against Lloyd.
Inside reverse to Thornton, who lost the football right at the 30-yard line, but flags are down, and Beechwood did recover the fumble, but we'll wait to see.
Again, if it's an illegal procedure penalty, the play does not count because
right.
It happened before the snap of the ball, and that's what the officials are talking over right now. Remember, it's early for them, too. Here comes Tommy Thompson with the call, and Beechwood's going to be upset about it, I believe, but that's what I saw.
Yep, the legal procedure against the Lloyd Juggernaut.
So, really, everything from there ends.
And we'll move it back to the 37-yard line.
with 3:12 to play.
Mike
Yeager
whips his hat up into the air, Randy, and that's going to cost Beechwood 15 yards. He didn't like the call, but Mike, if he didn't like it, he didn't see it. That's all I can say, because that was the exact proper call. If it's an illegal procedure penalty, that is the rule of football, and Tommy Thompson's going to have nothing to do with Mike Yeager. He might toss him from the game if he hears any more from the visiting coach.
Well, Tommy Thompson was over there talking with Mike Yeager.
And Tommy Thompson, the officials made the exact right call based upon the flag that was thrown prior to the snap of the ball.
Right.
That's an unsportsmanlike penalty. Cost Beechwood 15 yards. The Eagles trying to fire up his troops, but that will be a costly penalty.
Right, Kevin, the flag was thrown on illegal procedure penalty before the play actually started, so the play is dead before it ever starts. It doesn't matter what happens.
That's right.
Whether Lloyd scores a touchdown, whether Beechwood intercepts and runs for a touchdown, or the fumble, which actually did occur. And the play is dead the minute the penalty occurs, which was before the snap. So a correct call by the official. Get the ball at the 32-yard line. Now, this should mark it at around the 17, should it not, Kevin?
Well, what they're going to have to do first, Randy, is mark it back 5 yards.
Right.
And then they're going to advance the ball 15 yards from that spot. So that's where the placement of the ball will be marked down by the officials. But the exact right call, I really don't know what Mike was upset about, do you? I mean, Mike Woods down on the football field, can you think of anything that Mike Yeager would have been upset about, except the fact that his team didn't get the football? But certainly, after the illegal procedure call, as we said, that is the proper call by the officials.
Well, when I was over on the other side of the field, seeing the old man out of breath, I heard Mike Yeager complaining about the calls he was getting from this side of the field. It seems that he was concerned that every time they broke a big play, the yellow flag came out, and I think it probably just came to a head right there.
Well, he might have been complaining about it, but I got news for Mike. The penalty flag was thrown on his sideline that time, so and you know, Mike's a competitive guy, don't get me wrong. He's the heck of a coach. You know, he's won four state championships for the school in Fort Mitchell, but there I think he lost his cool, and quite frankly, either he doesn't understand the rules, or he just simply disagrees with the call. But if you disagree with the call, that's fine.
Third option is the fact that he knows the call is right, but he's trying to fire up the crowd.
Which I think he has done. But
right.
Let's see what happens. That can backfire on you as well. 7-6, 3 minutes to go in the third quarter.
Ball at the 21-yard line, and Lee will roll with it. On the right side, he's to the 20, cuts it to the outside, the 15, still on his feet, inside the 10, and run out of bounds. That will be down to the 5-yard line, so a big run for Jeremiah Lee down to the 5.
First and goal to go from the 5-yard line. Lloyd with the football at the far hash mark.
On the 5 with the football as Amney. He stood up right at the 5-yard line. Good defensive surge, and they're on the tackle. Getting up, big number. 62, that is Jeff Zeller.
Right into the near side this time. It's second down and goal from the 5 for Lloyd.
Lee underneath, second down, goal to go from the 5-yard line. He'll roll to the left. On the keeper, he's to the 4-yard line, diving, but did not make it to around the 2-yard line, and that'll bring up a third and goal to go from the 2.
Well, a good call, I think, the backfield. He's back in the game, so whatever he was taken out for, no longer a problem, and
Jeremiah Lee wants to time out.
Is going to call his second timeout, but that's all right. That's all right. Again, Triple will be the blocking back for Abney if Abney gets the ball.
Hits the ball. Abney with it. He didn't make it. Maybe a yard, and that's it. Joey lifts in there in a major league hurry. They shut down that hole, and that's going to bring up a fourth down. And now let's see what Rudy's going to do.
I'd go for it, Randy, now. I would absolutely go for it, even though
in there. They'll bring him up.
I'd watch Triple in this situation. He's big and strong.
And Abney in the backfield. Fourth and goal to go for the 1. Lee underneath. Quarterback keeper. And
yes,
he scores on the quarterback sneak. Over the right side, he just took it from the center and went between the center and the guard. 8-minute Adams for the 6.
And now you got to kick the extra point, Randy, so you got to
for 7 of the 13 judge points, and he'd like to make it 8 right here. Snap on the tee, kick is up, and it is good. 14-6, 8-point lead for Lloyd with 43 ticks left in the third. Stay with us on the Star Sports Radio Network.
Hi. For the Jugs, 8 straight runs, and really, I think Jeremiah Lee is a big cog on that drive.
Well, standing back at the 5, flanked by Wayne Scott and Bishop. Here's the kick. Oh, booming kick by Lee into the end zone.
Touchback automatically.
That will be a touchback as Coyle goes a step deep to gather it in.
Good call again by the official. Again, at the high school level as well as at the college level. Deion Sanders going offensive and defensive. Jeremiah can play offense, defense, and special teams. Beechwood, very important drive now for them to respond.
First down for the 20. Wisher on the pitch to the outside. Bishop's got some running room to the 25. Still on his feet, close to the 30-yard line. Knocked out of bounds.
And a late flag. That's going to be a personal foul against Lloyd.
Eric Lamer in on the stop. And I believe Mike Wood down there on the sideline might have seen a little bit better than us. Mike looked like maybe a late hit.
Some guys that are in the football game right now. A guy that's been pretty quiet offensively has been missed. He did have one pass thrown to him here in the second half, but he did not hang on. He had three catches for 72 yards in half number one.
Right out to both sides. Here's the pitch. Around the right side, Wolfbeck with the football. He slips at the 43-yard line as he's trying to make his cut inside. And that is just up to the original line of scrimmage, and I'll bring up a second down and...
And Red Dog Doherty, assistant coach for the Highlands Bluebirds now. Fourth and final quarter beginning. Beechwood down by 8 points, 14-6.
Second down and 10. Wisher once again underneath. Bishop goes in motion. Wisher will go back to throw. Throws over the middle. Got Ratliff. Ratliff at the 50-yard line will haul it in. Not a first down, but it'll bring up a third down and three with the ball resting right at midfield.
Just don't seem to be in sync yet, but it still is early in the season.
Wide out to both sides on this third down and three. Wisher underneath, five formation for Beechwood. And a handoff is straight up the middle with the football. And the running room is Bishop. Bishop to the 35-yard line, inside the 30, and down to the 28. John Baker in on the tackle, and Wisher did a great job of selling that. I thought for a second,
Randy, but nevertheless, Bishop does pick up a first down for Beechwood, and they do respond. Ryan Bishop now lined up in a slot to the near side.
And with the handoff now, Bishop with the football. Brian Bishop around the right side of the 25. He's to the 20. He's to the 15-yard line and run out of bounds. Inside the 15. In fact, they'll mark him all the way to around the 10-yard line. Call it the 11. And another first down at Beechwood all of a sudden.
There's no quit in the Beechwood Tigers.
First and goal from the 11-yard line. High formation. Here's the pitch to the outside with the football. Here's Bishop. He'll lose one tackler. He's inside the 10 to around the 9. And Chris Adams in on the tackle. Did a good job because he was really stood up at around the 14-yard line. But to
get a touchdown, because they need a touchdown on this drive. They cannot settle for a field goal. And really, their kicking game was off on the extra point try earlier.
Bishop in the backfield. Now Brian Bishop goes in motion on this second down. Wisher will roll to the right. Looking downfield, steps up in the pocket, throws incomplete. Trying to go to Estep. And Estep ran it inside a while. It looked like it was Wisher that wanted him to go out.
The scheme somewhere. Third down and 8 would seem to be an appropriate time. He's lined up at the tight end spot on the far side.
Wolfpack the low back. He moves. There's movement. And now the flag goes. Back to throw. Over the middle. Knocked up in the air.
Intercepted.
But this is going to come back. This is going to come back, Kevin. Much like the other one, is it not?
This actually, Randy, is going to be a motion penalty against Beechwood. They'll have to sort it out. But Jeremiah Lee is the guy that came up with the interception. So, Randy, the motion penalty will not come back. And that will be an interception for Lloyd. So, an illegal procedure penalty was on the offensive line for Lloyd.
Okay.
And this time it was motion in the backfield, as you said. That means the play can continue. Turn it over for the second time tonight for Beechwood. And the interception thrown by Wisher. Jeremiah Lee picks it off. And Lloyd, what did you do now?
It was Wolfpack, Kevin, that was caught leaning. You could see him leaning, anticipating the snap count. He actually took a whole step before the ball even came off.
And the ball is resting at Lloyd's own 5-yard line.
There's the handoff straight up the middle with the football. It's Kleiner. And Kleiner goes to about the 9. End of about 4. 9:49 and counting. So Jeremiah Lee picked off the... But to bring up a second down at 5 with the ball resting at the 10-yard line. And now Lee will go back and talk to his tailback before he comes up under center. Now a hand off to that tailback. That's Andy up the middle to near the 25-yard line. That's going to be enough. Well, check that, the 15-yard line. But that's going to be, I believe, enough for the first down as they'll mark it down at the 18.
He's very, very close if he didn't make it. Continue play for Beechwood. 9 minutes to go in the football game. It's Lloyd 14 and Beechwood 6.
First down. Lee on the option. He'll keep the football to the 20-yard line, to the 25, and still on his feet. Finally brought down at the 27. Brian Bishop in on the tackle, but good yardage once again, close to the first down. I believe he might be just a tad short, Kevin, but a good run for Lloyd in terms of passing, but his running has been so effective tonight for Lloyd. Now Lloyd goes to the wishbone, full house backfield, and here's the handoff into the gut. of Cecil, and Cecil's still on his feet.
He's
still
fighting
for
down.
Some yardage. He gets to the 34 and a late flag. And now there's a fumble on the field. Beechwood says they've got the football.
They do.
And they do at the 34-yard line.
Well, Cecil tried too hard that time. Brad Doss came up with a fumble recovery, but Cecil was fighting for extra yardage when he probably should have gone down. He picked up 4 yards, and then Beechwood smartly slipped him up. Eyes the Jeremiah Lee interception, and now it's first and 10 for Beechwood, and you got to figure that it'll be the Brian Bishop show from here on out for the Tigers.
Wolfek, give off to Bishop. He'll lose the football. He still doesn't have it yet, and I believe he covered back up finally at around the 41-yard line. They faked it to the inside man, pitched it to the outside. It never did get the football off.
And I don't think either team played very well last week, Randy, but I was very disappointed with the way Ryle lost last week down at the Thoroughbred Bowl. Now Beechwood doesn't see what they like offensively. They're going to call a timeout. We'll keep it right here. 7:48.
4-0 on the clock. It's obviously they celebrated early, and they got burnt.
They paid the price for that.
Second down and 20. And
the other side,
it's Wayne Scott, and back to throw. Wisher,
he is
pressured, and he is dropped. Back at the 47-yard line. Heavy pressure. Rocky Asher in there from the left side. Also, Corey Stiffel coming right up the gut. And that's going to bring up now a able to pull off another miraculous comeback when Cecil fumbled the football, but they've gone the wrong direction their last two offensive plays.
Third down at about 35. Wisher now will come underneath, right off to both sides, man in the slot. Wisher will go back. Look, goes left side for Eastep. And Eastep pulls it in at the 20-yard line, and he's down to the 13. Don Brown back on the defense that time, but Brown never saw the ball. The step caught it, and it'll be first down now for the Beechwood Tigers.
I think he might have fell right on the football. It will mark him down actually at the 11-yard line. Just a simple fly pattern, and Brown did have some pretty decent coverage, but you're right, Kevin. He didn't
touch anything like that. I'll try to get a hold of Bob Manzini when he gets back on the field and see if I can find out anything.
Thanks a lot, Mike. It's first and 10 for Beechwood.
Things getting interesting now. The 16, handoff right up the middle to Bishop. Bishop with some pretty good running room down to inside the 10-yard line. In fact, close to the 5. They'll mark him down at the 6.
Well, Randy, and then the 2-point conversion to knock this thing up.
Second down and 5 from the 6. Now a little bit miscommunication. Ratliff on the left side now moves over to the right. And here's a handoff straight up the middle. There's a Bishop with the football. Pounds inside the 5. But I don't believe he made the first down. Corey Stiffel in on the tackle. And that's going to bring up a third down at about 2, Kevin. With the ball at the 4-yard line.
Again, I think perhaps a play action pass for Lift might be in order here.
Wisher wants his man out in the flat area.
Morrison.
Finally, Morrison does go out there. They're going to have to hurry to get this playoff. Third down, handoff Bishop. Bishop up the middle, close to first down yardage. And I believe he might have made it. Looks like they're going to mark it down to close to the 1-yard line. That would be enough for the first down shot and the in on the tackle.
And the measurement, I believe.
Yeah, they're going to move it back actually to the 2, and it's going to be real close to first down yardage. What about it, Mike? You're down there. Can you see it? Do you know definitely yet?
Well, Beechwood gamely coming back on this one, and
at the 1. And the keeper by Wisher off the left side. Did he get in? No signal yet. Now, yes, they do say he got into the end zone. Off the left side as he went over Zellin and Gabbard. And Wisher scores from a yard out to make it 14-12 with 4:45 to play. And now the 2-point conversion.
Here's the most important play of the football game, Randy. It's now 14-12. Right on top by 2. Last year. And again, it's really been the ground game. But the big pass play on that drive is the 40-yard pass from Wisher to Eastep.
Full house back here for the 2-point conversion. Wisher with a pitch to Bishop off the right side, looking for the goal line.
No, sir.
He did not get it. He is stopped cold. Inside, Andy was there. Merritt was there. The linebacker smothering the pitch play. And Lloyd retains the lead, 14-12. What a
fails at 14-12. Lloyd, what will Beechwood do? Will it be the onside kick off of the foot of Adam Wolfek, or will they kick deep?
Fans team is in for Lloyd. They just brought in a couple of receivers in that front line, so they certainly think it's going to be an onside kick.
So Wolfek with his hand first. The ball has to go across midfield before anybody can touch it.
Wolfek will approach, and he'll move it.
That's a
short kick. It'll be short. Comes down to the
20, and a fumble. And Lloyd's got the football at the 20-yard line as it came into one of the up man's hands.
I believe that was Baker that
was Baker. Baker actually turned around to see what Brown was going to
total yards, but 4:40 to go. It'll be eye formation in the backfield for Lloyd.
Ball at the 20-yard line in the eye. Lee with the keeper off the left side, looking for some running room, maybe 2 yards to the 22. And then on the tackle was Josh Moore. And a gain of a couple.
Backing the line of scrimmage and the ball carriers, and I think in particular, quarterback Jeremiah Lee, who likes to run the option.
Stiffle and Abney in the eye formation on this second down. And Lee will go back and roll out to the left, looking for some running room. And the flag is down.
And it's going to be a hold on the tight end. Rowan on the far side. This play will cost Lloyd penalty yardage, as Beechwood, I'm sure, will accept that penalty.
Lee gets dropped at the 21-yard line, or will they, Kevin?
Yep, I take the penalty.
Holding penalty is called.
Remember, you only need a field goal, Randy, to take the lead in this game, and I think that's important. Lloyd's offense, I think, has been completely stifled. I mean, I haven't seen one thing offensively from Lloyd tonight. I would take the penalty yardage. What will Mike Yeagle do? He will not.
Fine.
And that's why he has 4 state champions. I don't think I really agree with that, but we'll find out soon.
Third down and 8. Lee underneath on his 3rd and 8. And he'll go back. Roll to the right. Look down.
Brown
steps up to the pocket. Now flushed out. Still looking.
Brown.
He went downfield. Brown is wide open and makes the catch at the 47-yard line.
Now, Randy, credit Jeremiah Lee with that entire play. A 25-yard pass play. Lee's second
completion. Really quickly catch that and run for the end zone, but instead, he made sure he got the football and went down to the knee to gather it in. Here's the handoff. Abney straight up the middle near the 49-yard line. Gain of a couple. Josh Bishop in on the tackle. 2:55 to play, and now Beechwood will take a timeout.
I'm a valuable player of the game, as well as the victorious head coach. The conclusion of this one, Mike Wood will be down on the sideline.
Second down at 7. Lee will head off to Abney. Abney to the 50, to the 45. He's to the 40-yard line in Beechwood territory. And down to the 37. Scott Coyle in on the tackle. And that should be the dagger.
Well, 15-yard pickup by Abney. He's now got 10 carries. And we got him on the run. We got him on the move. He's got a tough job, and I think he's done a great job tonight catching all the injuries and the coaches.
Ball at the 38-yard line. Lee will hand it off. Abney up the middle of the 35 and 2 near the 33 with 2:13 to play.
You could see that they had the weaponry. This year, I'm really not sure that they do, Randy. I think the Bishop brothers are good, but they're not great like Beechwood has had back in the past.
Lee will roll to the right. I'm sure he'll keep it.
Stand down.
35, he's to the 30, still on his feet. And he's pushed back at around the 27-yard line, but that is once again close to first down yardage with a minute 27 to play. How about a Rocky Chevrolet player of the game?
No doubt. Nope. After 14-12, Lloyd can just kneel on the ball from here on out. And Beechwood really is helpless to stop Lloyd's victory tonight.
At the 27, Lee will give it off to Abney. Abney tripped up at around the 26-yard line with a minute 10 to play. Dan Woolley in on the tackle. And this will bring up the second down.
See you next year. It's been a good contest, and Lloyd looks like they're going to hang on, barring a major disaster for the Jets.
So second down and 8, but the real story is that clock that ticks away with 44 seconds to play.
Now they do look like they've got the prevent offense, as I like to call it, in there, with 3 backs in the backfield behind Lee, and he'll wait as long as he can and get this delay of game penalty, and then he'll just have to hike the ball one more time, and this one should be history.
So the delay of game will move it back 5, but it wasn't actually pretty, and special teams did half of the work.
Yep,
and the defense did most of it. But the Lloyd Juggernauts are going to win this at 14-12 and go to 2-0 on the season.
Well, Randy, again, Lee did not have a good passing night. 2 of 10 for 40 yards tonight. But he did run the ball 11 times for 66 yards and the lone offensive touchdown. But boy, the 12 plus, I think maybe the biggest play he had in the game was the interception that he had after the motion penalty was called against Beechwood. The play was still live, and Lee picked the ball off inside the 10-yard line.
Lee will go back, touch it down on one knee. We're down to 30 seconds to play, and they won't have to run another one. Jeremiah Lee comes over, does a little cheerleading, raises his hands to the crowd. For the second year in a row, it looks like the Lloyd Juggernauts are going to win it, 14-12. Last year by 1 point, 21-20. And last year they did it with an offensive surge in the waning moment. This year they did it by stifling the 2-point conversion that could have tied it in the final couple of minutes in this game. This year by 2, last year by 1. 2 wins in a row, and that is it. 4-0 on the board. 14-12, the Lloyd Juggernauts have defeated the Beechwood Tigers. We'll take a break and be back after this on the Star Sports America Stop Game of the Week.
And tonight's game also brought to you by Rob Key Chevrolet.